Today you will learn about the fight-flight-freeze response, including how it works, how it can affect your mental health, and what you can do to calm it down. What is the fight-flight-freeze response? The fight-flight-freeze response is an automatic, brain-based survival response that each person experiences when they feel threatened emotionally or physically. This automatic response is the foundation for several mental health symptoms, including anxiety, anger, and stress. The fight-flight-freeze response is a survival instinct that is designed to help protect you from dangerous and life-threatening situations. It allows you to react quickly when you are in harm's way by either fighting off the threat, fleeing to safety, or shutting down until the threat passes. What happens in your brain and body? When you encounter a threat, a part of your brain called the amygdala acts as an alarm and sends an instant distress signal to another part of your brain called the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus activates something called the autonomic nervous system, or ANS. This system regulates your body's automatic functions, such as breathing, heart rate, and digestion. The ANS has two parts that each play a role in your body's fight, flight, freeze response. The first part is the sympathetic nervous system, which activates your fight or flight response like a gas pedal on a car. The other part is the parasympathetic nervous system, which acts as a brake and helps the body calm down once the threat has passed. The parasympathetic nervous system is also like an emergency brake that activates the freeze response during a threat. When the sympathetic nervous system is activated, it sends a signal to the adrenal glands in the kidneys. The adrenal glands release the stress hormones cortisol and adrenaline into your bloodstream, which cause common changes in your body that help protect you from danger through fight or flight response. These body changes include faster heartbeat, tense muscles, and rapid breathing, which helps to push blood, oxygen, and energy to your muscles and other vital organs to help you either defend yourself or run away as fast as possible. Your brain becomes more alert, and your sight, hearing, and other senses become sharper to help you better respond to the threat. You might start sweating to help your body cool down. As blood flows away from non-vital organs, body functions like digestion are put on pause. This might cause you to feel butterflies or pain in your stomach. When your parasympathetic nervous system slams on the emergency brake for your freeze response, your heart rate and breathing slow down, and your body movement often stops to help you avoid detection from the threat. As you can imagine, having the ability to fight, flight, or freeze when your life is in danger can be a very helpful survival mechanism. The downside of the fight, flight, or freeze response. The downside of your survival brain is that it can overreact in situations that are not truly life-threatening. Since your survival brain is designed to react instantly to a threatening situation, it often cannot tell the difference between an actual threat and stress that is not truly a threat. This can cause your body to go into fight, flight, or freeze mode in situations that are stressful but harmless. For example, you might yell at your parents for repeatedly reminding you to do your chores when you're in the middle of playing a game. Or you might see a stick on the ground while you're going for a walk and mistake it for a snake, which causes you to jump back and run away. Or your mind might go blank when you're giving a presentation in front of your class. These examples can help you see how the fight, flight, freeze response can lead to high anxiety, anger outbursts, and overwhelming feelings of stress during normal activities that do not pose a threat to your survival. How to calm your fight, flight, freeze response. Some of the best activities you can do to help calm your fight, flight, freeze response include relaxation skills, such as tensing and relaxing your muscles, stretching, or grounding yourself by noticing one or more of your five senses. Physical activity and talking with a trusted person can also help calm your overactive brain. Another scientifically proven technique to shift your brain out of survival mode is called diaphragmatic breathing or belly breathing. Taking deep belly breaths with slow breaths in and long breaths out is great for activating the parasympathetic nervous system, which calms your body and shifts you from survival brain to thinking brain. Researchers have found that as little as 1 minute of slow, deep breathing can greatly reduce your body's stress response. So the next time you feel anxious, angry, or stressed out, take a moment to take some deep breaths or use a relaxation skill to calm yourself down. This can help you think more clearly and have greater control over your fight, flight, or freeze response. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe. For more social, emotional, and mental health resources for kids and teens, please visit www.mentalhealthcenterkids.com. Thanks for watching!